Gay films have been the unspoken, unheralded leader in the social acceptance of gay men in America, the changing of laws, and in pushing gay society out of the closet around the world. Then don't you ever fucking forget that.
I think we can thank Chuck Holmes for taking porn out of the dirty bookstore and into the living room.
The style of model, the style of grooming, all of that was Chuck's personal desire.
He was not a creative person at all. He was a business person. But he did have some basic instinct around quality.
He would shoot the product, he would edit the product, he would dupe the product, offer it for sale, and then send the stars out to make personal appearances.
VHS broke. I couldn't believe how much money there was.
We have to understand is that it was extremely risky. And Chuck carried on in a manner that caused a lot of attention.
Cops came barreling into my house, and the boys were right in the middle of their cum shots.
Despite all the money that he had, despite the cars and the boats and the travel, he felt that his money would never stick with him if he didn't give a lot of money away.
He was never really comfortable with what he chose as his career. And I think that the philanthropy made him more comfortable.
He, and you brought up Terry Bean earlier, were really some of who we referred to as the founding fathers of HRC, because they really started the whole organization.
Everybody, even in politics, knew they were coming to him for his money.
No one minded getting Chuck's money, but some of them minded where it came from. He was a pornographer. We don't want that porno, dirty money.